Hello and welcome to Trujillo. It's been quite a long time since the Albatros last flew, so let's remedy that and go on with my world around the world tour using the Albatros. Of course, with how things currently are, it will take about forever, but let's go on with the South American part of it. And today we are going to fly from Trujillo to Jorge, Chavez International Airport in Callao. It should be about half an hour or to an hour, we will see. And as usual, we are only going to use VORs and ILS to navigate. So let's hop into the airplane and let's start it up. We will need the fuel valve open. We will need battery, engine systems and avionics on, and it will take a while to boot up, and in the meantime I will just show you what we are going to do. So right now we are at Trujillo Airport. We are going to take off from runway 20, head to VOR station Bravo Tango Echo, and from then on towards the Jorge Chavez Airport. It has a very close VOR station. We are going to tune in into that once we are over BTE, because its signal will be of course easier to capture, and once we are around the airport we will switch over to the ILS. So this is the plan for this flight. Let's hide it now. Enter for the GNS and let's start up the APU. We are not going to use GPS, we are going to use VLOC. And while the APU runs up, we can already set the Trujillo VOR station as our first one, which is 116.3. And from there we are going to fly a heading of, let's close it, we are heading of 154. Let's also set heading back to 154. Right now, the altimeter setting here is 1011, which we cannot change to be in hectopascals, but luckily it's 2985. So 2985 and borrow. All right. With that, now the APU should be fully on. Let's start the engine. It doesn't take much for the for to start up the Albatros, but as usual we will need to monitor if it does happen, because with the Albatros it sometimes does not happen. Oh, wouldn't be a bad idea. Once we have oil pressure in the green, we will know that it is a good start. And with that, we can have the generator and the alternators on. Taxi lights on. Strobes on. Nav lights flash. Let's not forget the pitot heats before taking off. We can already set flaps takeoff. And we need one notch of trims to take off. Unfortunately, the autopilot does not accept preselected values for preselected modes. I can set, of course, altitude, let's say. Let's start with 7,000 feet. And we have already set the cruise and the heading. With that, we are ready to roll. So let's ask the tag to push us back. While it gets to the airplane, I will just show you that Trujillo Airport is really small. So once we get to this exit just behind us, we will taxi back to the northern part of the airport, to the runway, and take off as runway 20. Seems like now it spawned on its place, so let's release the parking brake and let's have it push ourselves back. I'm not sure we should have turned on the engine within the red line, but we did. I think that's just enough. So parking brake on. Let's send the tug away. I'm really satisfied with the free patchback helper add-on I got downloaded. It really does the job. And of course it's free. Okay, we are going to turn right onto the runway, so let's turn on landing lights. And with the guy now sufficiently away, let's roll. Clear left, clear right. Let's keep to the right of the runway. It will be easier to turn around. We will need a bit of help to see our ground speed. Oh, come on. For a while now, even with almost any planes that I fly, there's this weird drift going on. I don't think there is such a huge wind at the moment that would justify almost instantly and hard turn to the right if I'm not on the rudder pedal. So that is runway 20 identified. No runway 20, no ATC. We are alone today with this airplane in disguise, so I assume we are clear to take off. Quite some rudder to keep alive. But once we are in the air, it completely disappears, so I don't think it should be allowed because of the wind. Okay, gears up, 200 knots. Flaps up is of course. The heading back and turn on autopilot heading mode, flight level change. And let's climb with 300 knots. And even on a 300 knot climb, we are climbing by 4,600 feet a minute, so it will not take us long to be on 7,000 feet. Unfortunately, the airport is not visible from this distance. But that reminds me to... Well, first let's get up to... Let's say 30,000. No, not with 400, let's just stick with 300, not climb. Let's go 15,000. And now we are over 10,000 feet, so landing lights may be off. Of course, Peru has some serious wealth in terms of geography, but we are not going to fly over the mountains, not yet. I plan to take this flight, this around the world flight, towards Cusco, but that will be another stop, another leg in the tour. Let's switch over to VTE 112.5. Should be able to see it. And continue our 154. Radio to it. Check the VOR station. That's the airport, but I want the VOR station. .9R. So let's already switch it at our standby. We have overshot the radio as usual. that with a bit of time we will capture it. But what I really love about this airplane is its absolute power, even in low altitudes. Just check it out, 451 knots, even at 15,000 feet. I'm right, then ETE should be the VOR station of that airport, so we are soon going to lose. We might already have lost signal. Not yet. Now signal is lost, but we will have it back once we are properly over it. Just not forget to switch nav mode back on, because it automatically switches off when it lost the signal. The next station is about 192 nautical miles according to Sky Vector, and we should be flying 156 radial outwards, so let's change it to 156. see if we can. Okay, what am I doing now? Okay, so let's see if we can capture now the Callao 4 station. No, we can't. But as always, one needs to switch back and hold on. And now we have the Callao VOR station, so it will be more precise to drive towards it than to climb outwards from our previous radio. At least I like better to fly towards something than away from something when flying VOR to VOR. 7 now, 2.5 miles, which should be less than a quarter of an hour at this speed. As for the ILS, is 109.7. Runway is at 45 feet, so if we are to lose 15,000 feet in 15 minutes or so, we should probably start to lose a bit of altitude. Well, either we start now about 1,100, or let's make a bit further and descend a bit steeper. Probably be able to take taxiway Bravo inside, and might even get this small patch of apron, or use the rear part of that apron. This is 11,500 long, so we should be pretty much able to exit at Bravo, but if not, then we will exit at Charlie. I'd rather have a nice soft landing than force it onto the runway early. That is more or less 50 degrees. just a quick check. That local human age is 111. Local QNH is 112.1012. Oh, that's no use. 2988. So 2988 and 2988 here as well. Also, we can turn on landing lights now. Flaps and gears can wait. Oh, and we should be decelerating. 350 knots is a bit much at this altitude. I think we can pull our nose a bit up. At this speed we are getting down too quick. Like we either decelerate or accelerate, I cannot move the throttle so little that it actually keeps the speed where it is. Into the clouds we go, but no worries about ice. There is almost 20 degrees outside. Well, actually, let's slow down to 220. Is that already the runway? Could be. It's 15 miles away. Accelerate a bit more. And that is the runway in sight. 200 knots. Let's see our gears. Flap 1. A bit of thrust to counter that. I think we can switch over to the ILS now. Flaps 2. Concentrate now on the landing. Capture. So landing gear down, flaps full, speed brakes retracted, 130 knots. You know what, let's take over from here. Okay, I'm fine with this landing. And we also made it to the first exit, unless I am wrong. I will check the chart, of course, once we are clear of the runway. Of course, we could stop on the runway. There is no one else in the skies this time, but let's try to be well behaved. So we should be now pretty much off the runway. We are. And we did. We did make it to the first exit. So let's try to find ourselves some nice place to park. Close the chart. Take a left here. We don't want to get to the gates. Let's leave those for the big boys. Let's just make it to the end of this line and switch things off. Okay, so lights off. Oh, engine anti-ice was not used. Strobes off. Nav lights off. Pitot heat wasn't even on. That's not ideal. Alright. Seems like we made it to Callao. I'm sorry, Callao. I hope you enjoyed the flight. We had a pretty nice view from up there. Peru is still a very good looking place to fly over. And we did quite a nice landing. And even managed to get out at the first exit as planned. I'm literally satisfied with this flight, but do tell me in the comments if you find it otherwise or if you are agreeing with me. Thank you for joining me for today and see you on our next flight. Goodbye.